Dit is Anna Rösling-Rönnlund. De Zweedse was vandaag de gast op het technologiefestival Supernova. Rösling-Rönnlund is de schoondochter van de bekende Zweedse professor Hans Rösling. Samen met haar inmiddels overleden schoonvader en haar echtgenoot schreef ze een boek over factfulness, een voorbeeld van hun onderzoek.
So in this end, at the far left, we have the absolute poorest here. And then imagine the street like this. And on the other end, we have the richest. Every figure here is 1 billion people. And then you have all the rest somewhere in between. So the world population today is 7 billion people. And most are in the middle. And we have asked Swedish students where they think they belong on this world income distribution. And they would actually point out that they are here, in the absolute middle. And most likely they think they are not the poorest because they are not starving, and they are not the richest, they are not Bill Gates, so they must be in the middle. But just living in Sweden means that you're most likely in the richest billion group.
If we're able to look at the world more fact-based, what we would see is that most things, or many things I should say, that many things are better than we assume. And that is the reason that the world is better than we assume. It's because we are driven by a negativity when we look around us, which is making it hard for us to understand the world around us. And I think this negativity will create a stressful feeling. But if we look at the world in a more factful way, I think we will get the energy to continue on solving big problems moving ahead.
Het wereldbeeld dat u dagelijks binnenkrijgt wordt vaak bepaald door berichtgeving in de media. En dat is geen al te fraai beeld. Heel vaak zijn het beelden van oorlogen, conflicten en rampen.
In the news we see all of these extraordinary things happening, which we should, because it's news. The news should report everything unusual, right? So I'm not blaming the media, but I'm saying when we don't have a baseline of common understanding about the global trends and proportions to lean on, our brains will actually screw it up a bit for us, because we will soon start thinking that what we have seen are the representative images from the world, which it's not, because we only see the exceptions.
Remember, an improvement would seldom get publicity. We never see this. Yesterday, all trains were on time again, because we always hear everything that doesn't work, but we forget to talk about what works and what are slowly changing positively.
Niet alleen de media hebben volgens Rösling-Rönnlund een grote verantwoordelijkheid. Ook zij die in de media komen, zoals bijvoorbeeld politici.
It's a very easy way of gaining popularity by doing polarizations and start a feeling of combat and it's now or never and urgency kind of stories and gap stories and negativity stories. I mean, that's how you can involve people and gain interest and start like a movement. So I think it's important that we, everyone, politicians and all the rest of us, train ourselves in being self-critical so that we can understand that we all are driven to those kinds of stories, but we should actually look at the data. And when we see that there is a discrepancy in the data, that usually shows that slow things are improving in many indicators. Not everyone, of course, but many things are slowly improving.
Ons baseren op feiten en dus minder op een negatief buikgevoel. Het is een nobele gedachte. Maar dan moeten alle juiste feiten en data wel voorhanden zijn. En onbetwistbaar. Want wat is de feitelijke waarheid?
We have a lot of available good data out there. But the thing is, we haven't really adopted to the whole landscape of loads and loads of information. So we have to train our species to deal with all this information and make sense out of it. And I think that is a slow process, and I think it starts in school, and I think it's something we might learn in, you know, and start adopting on a bigger scale maybe in 10 years from now, not today.
Thank you.